Hello students, Apna Study presents you the Hindu news bulletins for the 24th of July. Before we start, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.
National news. Budget allocation for the National Security Council Secretariat, NSCS, increased 10 times.
Budget allocation for the National Security Council Secretariat increased 10 times from 33.17 crore rupees in 2016-17 to 333.58 crore rupees in 2017-18. Senior lawyer Prashant Bhushan alleged that it was the year when the NSO Group of Israel, which has developed the Pegasus spyware, was paid hundreds of crores for snooping on several eminent individuals' phones.
COVID-19 vaccination among the fastest.
Former Congress Chief Rahul Gandhi was one of two MPs who had asked if all adults would be fully vaccinated by December 2021. Between August and December 2021, a total of 135 crore doses of COVID-19 vaccines are expected to be available. 9,725.15 crore rupees had been spent so far on the vaccination program.
The Indian monsoon floods across India.
Parts of western Konkan coast and southern peninsula seeing instances of extreme rainfall. Torrential rain is likely to continue for the rest of the week due to position of monsoon trough. July and August are the most important monsoon months, contributing over two-thirds of the seasonal rainfall. Climate scientists warn that monsoon patterns have been changing.
Navjot Singh Sidhu takes charge of the Punjab Congress Committee.
Navjot Singh Sidhu formally took charge of Punjab Pradesh Congress Committee on Friday. Chief Minister Amarinder Singh joined the event and congratulated Mr. Sidhu. Captain Amarinder had been maintaining that he will not meet him until he publicly apologizes for his social media attacks against him.
The road to a dignified life for all Indians.
Former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh marks the 30th anniversary of economic liberalization on July 24th. Dr. Singh says the country needs to recalibrate its priorities to a dignified life for all Indians. The social sectors of health and education have lagged behind and not kept pace with economic progress.
Former Congress President Rahul Gandhi demands resignation of Home Minister Amit Shah.
Rahul Gandhi demands the resignation of Amit Shah and a judicial inquiry by the Supreme Court against Prime Minister Narendra Modi for using the Pegasus spyware. The former Congress president said only those who were thieves or corrupt will get scared of Narendra Modi.
Brahmins to come together and showcase strength.
Mayawati-led Bahujan Samaj Party promises to expedite construction of the Ram Mandir in Ayodhya. BSP's National General Secretary and Brahmin face Satish Chandra Mishra launched a fresh outreach program for the community.
International news. The Taliban say they don't want to monopolize power.
Taliban say they don't want to monopolize power, but won't be peace in Afghanistan until a negotiated government is installed in Kabul and President Ghani is removed. The Taliban have captured territory in recent weeks, seized border crossing and are threatening a number of provincial capitals. The top US military officer, General Mark Milley, said that the Taliban have strategic momentum, and he did not rule out a complete Taliban takeover.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi declares a committee to investigate the Capitol insurrection.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says a congressional committee investigating the January 6th Capitol insurrection will take on its work whether Republicans participate. Republicans House Leader Kevin McCarthy called the committee a sham process and suggested that GOP lawmakers who take part could face consequences. Ms. Pelosi made clear that she won't relent, and Democrats mulled filling the empty seats themselves.
China's president visits Tibet.
China's President Xi Jinping is the first Chinese leader in many years to visit Tibet as well as its southeastern border region with India. He arrived in Tibet on Wednesday on a three-day visit, landing at the airport in Nangchi. This is Mr. Xi's first visit to the Tibet Autonomous Region since taking over as the General Secretary of the Communist Party of China in 2012.
Ben and Jerry's ice cream, the battle to end BDS in Israel.
US-based ice cream brand Ben and Jerry's has stopped selling its products to Jewish settlements in the Israeli-occupied Palestinian territories of East Jerusalem and West Bank. Israel Prime Minister Naftali Bennett has warned Unilever, the London-based parent company, of severe consequences over the decision. Israel seized the West Bank and East Jerusalem in the 1967 war and has promoted Jewish settlements.
Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan uses Israeli spyware Pegasus.
India allegedly eavesdropping on foreigners, including Prime Minister Imran Khan, using Israeli spyware Pegasus. Pakistan has urged the UN to thoroughly investigate the matter. Mr. Khan was a potential target of the Israeli-made Pegasus spyware program by clients of the NSO Group cyber espionage firm.
Business news. Amazon and Flipkart lose their legal battle in High Court.
E-commerce majors Amazon and Flipkart lost their legal battle in the High Court of Karnataka. A division bench upheld the Competition Commission of India's decision to conduct an investigation into whether they had entered into anti-competitive agreements in violation of the Competition Act, 2002.
Reliance reports first quarter results.
Reliance Industries Ltd. reported first quarter net profit rose 4.2% to 13,806 crore rupees. Revenue surged from 1,58,862 crore, up 57% from 1,00,929 crore a year earlier. CMD Mukesh D. Ambani, our company has delivered robust growth despite facing a highly challenging operating environment caused by the second wave of the COVID pandemic.
Sports news. Leica Kovai Kings vs Ruby Trichy Warriors.
Leica Kovai Kings beat Ruby Trichy Warriors by 8 wickets in Shriram Capital TNPL match. Ganga Sridhar Raju scored 74 and Sai Sudarshan 57 not out for Leica. Amit Sathwak and Nidhish Rajagopal, Sumant Jain, Antony Das 20, Abhishek Tambar 2 for 32, K. Vignesh 2 for 30, Selvar Kumaran 2 for 26.
Afi clears Sri Shankar and KT Irfan for the Olympics.
Long jumper M. Sri Shankar and race walker KT Irfan cleared for Tokyo Olympics. Afi conducted fitness trials for the two athletes in Bengaluru recently and made it clear that it was not happy with their form.